friends, welcome to my channel You and Me. Today's topic is pointers in C. Pointers, as the name suggests that it has to point to something, and what is that something, we will discuss it now. We know that every variable used in the program and machine instruction are stored in the main memory. And how the main memory looks like? Main memory consists of successive memory location, each having distinct address starting from 0 through 2 raised to k minus 1, where k is the number of the bits of the computer. So we have two choices of accessing the value stored in the variable. First one, bytes variable name, and second one, bytes associated address. So I will take two separate examples to illustrate both the cases. This is first case and this is second case. Here I have taken variable p and initialized the value 10 to the variable p. Then I will get a output. I will get an output 10 through printf statement. Printf statement consists of %dp. Here we are using variable name to get the value stored in the variable. So this is the first case example. So I will move on to second case example. In the second case also, I have taken the variable p and initialized the value 10 to the variable p. Then I have taken another variable x and assigned an address of the variable p to the variable x. We can get the address associated with the variable using an operator called as ampersand operator before the variable. This is called as the ampersand operator. It is the symbol of the ampersand operator. Next we have printf statement. Printf statement will give me the value stored in the variable x. So I will get the value 10. Why this star is used, I will tell you within 2 to 3 minutes. And note that this star is called as the indirection operator. Indirection operator. Okay. Here you can see that we are dealing with the address associated with the variable p. Suppose in the main memory, p is located at 500 memory address having the value 10. So I am assigning the address, that is 500, to the variable x. Now x is containing the address of the variable p. Then x is called as the pointer variable. Why it is called as the pointer variable? Because pointer variables are like normal variable but differ from the normal variable in the fact that they contain the address of another variable. Here x is containing the address of p. So we are indirectly accessing the value stored in the p through indirection operator with the variable x. So x is called as the pointer variable. And another point to note while dealing with pointer is that pointers are the derived data type. Okay. Now move on to the declaration part of the pointers. Declaration of the pointer variable takes the following form. This star tells the compiler that pt name is a pointer variable and this data type is not the data type of pointer variable but it is the data type of the variable to which pointer variable is pointing. Okay, once declaration of the pointer variable has been done, then compiler will allocate a memory location to the pointer variable. Since pointer variable have not been initialized any value, so it may contain unknown value. Hence, pointer variable will point to unknown location. Therefore, initialization of the pointer variable is required. And how the initialization takes place, I will show you. Here I have taken the data type as data type of the variable. Then this data type of the pointer variable should be same as the data type of the variable, otherwise our program will give us erroneous result. Then for example, integer pointer variable can point to only integer data type. It cannot be made to point to other data types such as float, etc. Then this is the initialization part. Here data type star, pt name, ampersand. Here I have assigned the address of the variable to the itni pointer variable. This is all about the pointer variable. If you like my video, please subscribe to my channel and press on notification bell to get updated with my channel. Thank you.